Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. I just wanted to do a quick review of the market and what I'm expecting for the coming week. So if you can check, this is cable GBP USD. So what I'm expecting on this one, let me go to daily. If you guys remember, you go back to my post and the video that I've been posting, you see there is one video where I was talking about this GBP USD, where it's going and where market is gonna start buying. As you can check, market get on this level and market start doing what? Market start buying. So market bought from this level. This is our HTO, because market returned to the other block. Then market push. Can you see our market push up very hard? So from what we were expecting right now, I'm expecting a continuation on the buy side. I feel like market has to drop again a bit. If you go to H4, then from H4 you'll see properly. So I'm expecting market to come from this level, because if you can check, this is our other block level. If you can check here, so I'm expecting for market to come on this zone here, test this zone, buy, cross this level, because this is a level of liquidity. If you can check, this is a level of liquidity. And then our target, the big target, is on this level here. So market to buy something like this from this zone. You're gonna have, I'm sure, something like this. We just buy there, and then we return just for retest. Retest, then we fly up like this. So this is how I'm expecting to see on GBP USD, something just like this. Then the next one on my list is GBP GPY. Also, I'm expecting a short. So I'm just gonna focus more on short than on long, because from my expectation, I want it to go up here. As you can check, test this level, then drop. As you can check, we have an impulsive movement. This is a big correction. Then from this big correction, as I explained to you guys, I'm expecting a short. So I'm gonna start looking for sell when market get on this level. So I'll start looking for sell when market get on this level. This is why I mark my level to start selling, so that I can come down to this level. Let me check here. So if you can check, we've got a big, very big correction here. So I'm expecting market to come and test this level. Then from here we see if market is gonna continue dropping. So if market drop, then we see something, market is gonna come and test this zone. That depends on how the market is going to play on this level, or from this level, then we're gonna continue here to come and look for another touch, so that market can drop again. Let's see, this is the true possibility of this market. But so far, this is not what I'm focusing on. What I'm focusing on is for me to sell from this zone here. So if market continue up here, then I sell from this level. This is the second thing that I was focusing on. Then the third one is EURGPY. EURGPY also, I'm expecting first a buy when market open. I'm expecting a buy when market open. So what I'm doing is I'm expecting a buy to buy from this level when market open. get on this zone here, then I'll look for a sell from this level. Why I'm saying I'll look for a sell, because remember market drop here, then this is a pull, sort of a pullback. The market is pulling where? Market is pulling to this entry, to our OT entry. And if you check on the OT entry, we've got another order block on the OT entry. Let's check this level, OT entry. Then on top of that, if you see, we have an OT entry here, then we've got a order block. As the bank, they must mitigate here, they must mitigate here. So what is going to happen? Something like this. So if market can cross this level, then the next level that is going to hold the market is this OT entry. But so far we're expecting to sell from this 62%. Then if we sell from there, then our target is for us to come and remove this liquidity. So we're going to see something like this. Or if it's continue going more down, then we see it touching this zone here. So let me zoom for you guys, so that you can see which zone is the target. Can you see? This is where we think we see like it's gonna be our target from this level. So let's see how market is going to play from that level. And another one that I'll focus on more on the coming week, as Nasdaq, I don't like analyzing it before the market open. Why? One of the reasons is because Nasdaq always give us a gap. You see when Nasdaq open, it always open with a gap. As you can check how nice Nasdaq was buying when markets close. So maybe sometimes you can see these things already pulled down, then we have a gap. But so far, if you can check on this zone here, we have a nice order block here before the market, I think it was around 3, where market dropped to this level. Check, then we bought very hard. The market continue up. So let me go to H1, so that you can see on H1. I like trading Nasdaq on H1, so I like trading it on H1 properly. Check what happened here. Market come down here, test the level, then bought very hard, goes up. So what I'm gonna wait for the coming week is something like this. Wait for the market to come down on this level here, buy again, create a double top, then from the double top here, then I'll look for a sell from this level so that we can come to this zone here. You guys get the sense? So this is what I expect from Nasdaq. So from the Nasdaq, it's so simple. Just look for a double top from this zone here. We come and start selling. That's, but the condition must be market has first to drop this level here. Then from this level we buy again to the top there. Then from the top, this is when we see market coming down and targeting which level, because we've got almost 3 levels that is gonna be like a target for the coming week. So as you can check, this is the most significant low where I would like to see the market come and test. Then we have all this low here. So this is the low, and we have another low this side. This is another one. Yeah, so all this low here, this is how I'm expecting market to come and play. Then we've got this liquidity. This is what I'm expecting us to come and test again this zone. As you can check, Nasdaq, since to break this level, we need to come back to come and test this zone. So we expect something like this. But on top of that, we have a nice other block that can even push the market down to come and test. If you remember, Nasdaq always play where there is a other block. To always make sure to go to the other block. So if you can check even this side, Nasdaq always come to the order block, collect orders, then goes up, something just like this. This is for us. Then gold, since it is on my top 6, the one that I'll focus more, then gold also I'll continue looking for a buy. continue looking for a buy. I'm not there for sell, so I'll continue looking for buy. That is going to be the focus of gold. But so far, this is the important things that I'll focus more on the coming. So it's this one, this and this. Those are the four stuff I'll focus more. Because the GBP, USD card, as long as I know what is going to play GBP USD, because this one, it just fails to come and touch this level here on top here. And then at the same time, that side we have also another drop. Then when this one is dropping to this level here, then this is when also I'll look for a proper buy. So this buy, I'm sure this time when it's buying, it's gonna come to this target here. Just something like this. This also depends on the strength of the dollar. So what is gonna happen with dollar? So if the dollar index continue pushing up, we see this one also push up just like this. So simple, sharp guys.